Yeah, that's my favorite album of last year. I liked it more than the Tame Impala album and the Django Django album and all the other stupid music I listened to. It's the Blur album, The Magic Whip. First one was There Are Too Many of Us. This one's Ghost Ship. I tried to sing to it, and then I realized there's a delay on my microphone. So I can't, but I can do this. Someone requested I do this, so I'll do this.
I got away for a little while, but then it came back much harder.
And there's Satan singing the Ghost Ship song. It's really good stuff. I'll tell you a little story before I get started with Monster Hunter. While I'm getting started with Monster Hunter, the story is that I saw Blur, Shrieding Crab won tickets and couldn't make it to the show. There was a really small show, Williamsburg Hall of Music in Brooklyn, for Blur, like 500 people. You know, really small gig for Blur. And it was like you could only win tickets. And I mean, Shrieding Crab gave me the tickets because there was, yeah, it was pretty cool. And I will never forget that ever. And it was one of my favorite shows I've ever been to. I was real, real close. Hang on, let me see if I can show you guys something. I was really, really up front for that particular show. I had a... Where the fuck is it? I had a folder called Blur. Oh wait, I think it's over here. And it was just a few pictures that I took. Images? Blur. Yeah, I can show you just a few shitty camera, phone camera pictures. But there's one. And this is before I got a new phone, so my camera was even worse, which sucks. But I still managed to get... You can see how close I was to Alex James and to Damon. At one point, Damon was throwing water at the audience, and he got me. With a water bottle. With a little splash of water. That son of a bitch. So. Yeah, really, really great gig. And I think that show is partially why that album is my favorite of last year. So, anyway, we went and played Final Fantasy Explorers. And now, we're going to play Monster Hunter 4 Ultimate. A game I have recently delved back into, and it's as good as I remember it. Maybe not as addictive as when I first played it, but it's still a really, really great game. And I don't want to compare and contrast too much. I'll let you guys do that if you want to. So I'll try not to bring up Final Fantasy Explorers too much. I'll try to let you guys make your own comparisons and see what's different. But it's been a long ass time since I played this. I am super rusty. That is my jabroni character, and that is my cat, Sklumpet. He has one eye, and he's a half Mario, half Luigi cat. And I have to change the fucking info. Hang on a sec. Monster Hunter 4. Monster Hunter 4. Yeah, I have a pretty interesting set. I guess you can say my name is Skullface. This is my current set. It's not much different than the last time I streamed this game. Except I have this now, so sharpness, you know. I have a few skills that are critical eye, plus one, defense up small, razor sharp, which I can mix and match. Cats, please. So, I need to do a few... I need to do a few quests, actually. Hunt a Lagombi and a Red Kezu. Or a Naharala. Two Naharala. No, I don't want to do that. I'm gonna do, I'm gonna do this one. Primal Pests. Because I need to start... Since I'm kind of working my way back into the game very slowly, it would probably be a good idea for me to, start with some of the town quests. And just try to get back on the saddle. Hairy Tuna and King Turkey. I will show you the cats. I will show you how they cook. Watch them cook. Am I doing multiplayer tonight? Maybe. Maybe I'll do a town quest or two and then I'll do multiplayer. Just one. I don't know. It's already getting late and I have practice tomorrow and I don't want to go to bed like too late. So I'll probably stop in an hour. Whatever we can get done in an hour, I'll try to just do that. Items away. All right, so I need to bring some. Okay, hang on a second. This is not going to make sense for a lot of new viewers to this game who have never seen a Monster Hunter game. This game is crazy. There's just so much shit to do in it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take these items that were made on a farm. And I'm gonna... there's still 2 days left, okay, so... what I have to do is make potions, right? So, this game does... You combine things. Alright, you combine items, so we're gonna do a sort. Yes. And I'm gonna make some potions, and you do that with an herb and a blue mushroom. So we're making fuckload of potions. Fuckload of potions. There's a 100% success rate when making potions. I have a... I think that increases over time anyway, if I remember correctly. So I'm gonna then make super potions, which is honey plus potion. And I have a fuckload of honey, so we're gonna make a fuckload of super potions. There we go. I'll actually make a few more now that I realize you can hold A. Thank you, chat. Alright, so, then I sort again, and this is all just stuff, just pieces of monsters, just various gems and things. And, traps and stuff. Lots of stuff that you would use in your monster hunting. However, since I am still pretty rusty, I'm just gonna take just a few things. Okay, let me store some of this. I got my hot and cold drink, pickaxes, whetstones, honey in case I need it on the way, and, I got my cats. I'll introduce you to my cats. Asshole! And someone else. Oh, Sklumpet. Oh, thank you, Carlo, for the sub. I don't know, I mean, I was looking at the game, sorry. Carlo. But thanks. Vinny, did you get the DLC? No. It's been a while since I played the game, so I have not booted up the DLC to download. I kind of wish it would happen automatically, but you have to actually go and download it. Also, the new 3DS version of this looks a lot better because the textures are better, the monsters look better, like, the textures are improved, but, oh god, at the same time, Oh, fuck. Alright, well, I'm gonna go for this fucker. I'm already poisoned! Already setting traps. Asshole! Asshole! Whoops. So, a lot of... You'll notice a lot of, like, actions take a long time to do. Which can be kind of fixed with equipment and skills. Well, just skills, really. Like, I could make me putting my weapon away go faster if I really wanted to, if I upgraded it. Okay, so the Celtis is in a different location now. So I'm just gonna attack this thing in the face. Right? This is a switch axe, by the way. Yeah, nice. Okay, so you need to reload switch axes, which can be done in axe form. You know, if you want- yeah, I know, you have to reload a fucking sword. That's Monster Hunter for you. Oh no, I'm poisoned because I was in the poison. I don't have anything to make me not poisoned, so I can only hope that asshole fixes the problem, because asshole is a healer. So you gotta know when to attack, you gotta know the right move, which was not that at that moment. Definitely not. There's a lot of different types of playstyles in this game. A lot of different weapons, a lot of different types of attack patterns you can do. And you're given a lot of freedom on how you want to kill monsters, basically. And this is a very small monster. You know, like, this monster is like, fucking minuscule. Compared to some of the oh, fuck. Whoops, I had to reload. Oh, no, the fucking Celtis is here. That's gonna confuse things a little bit. Fucking with you yet, Seltzer. Speaking of, I'm thirsty, but I can't drink right now. Oh god! Okay, dinosaur is leaving. A giant fly is here. I'm still not fucking with giant fly. Giant fly can wait. So now, I have to find... If I had a paintball, I could have marked the red dinosaur fella, whose name escapes me at the moment. Iapetus? We're gonna find out the name of that fella. Iodrome. Iapetus is a moon that orbits Saturn. That's definitely not the name of that particular red dinosaur fella. I wonder, did he go through the poison that I didn't have to go through to get to the other side? I just poisoned myself for no reason. I really don't think Iodrome is up here, but... We could do a little mining. Change of scenery is always nice. Will I ever get a new 3DS? I do have a new 3DS. I have it, I use it for example, SteamWorld Dig and SteamWorld Heist. I have on my new 3DS. I play this on my new 3DS. I just don't want to mod it to have a big bulky capture card on it. I don't know if there's an easier way to stream from a new 3DS. There he is. Hey, where are you going? So this slime axe that I'm using, if I build up enough slime... on a monster, they explode. You'll notice, like, random explosions from time to time. That right there, that explosion was because I built up a lot of fucking slime. And it's non-elemental, too, so slime weapons are kind of amazing. I love them. So this weapon has two distinct attack modes. There's axe mode, which I'm in now, which is pretty powerful, but it's slow, and doesn't cost anything to use. You don't have to reload when you're in axe mode. It has a few really good attacks. Ashhole's playing the song of his people. You see that? That motherfucker just played a little song, and it healed me. So now I really just want these little fuckers to get out of here. Fucking explode on them. Okay, because they're just fucking up my attacks at this point. You see that? Little fucker. Ruin my strategy. Now he's limping. That means that this particular monster is weak. He is damaged. Yes, give me the trumpet. Yes, I love when you give me the trumpet, Squumpet. What's your first Monster Hunter game? Monster Hunter Tri on the Wii was my first Monster Hunter game, so I'm a latecomer to the series. Despite that, that's like, what, 6 years old now, that game. So, I mean, I've been on board for 6 years. I've played, three Ultimate. I've played this one. So, I mean, I'm a fan of the series. I'll pretty much buy, you know, I'm gonna buy Monster Hunter Cross. That's without a doubt. But, like I said, kind of a newcomer, but... probably got like 400 hours total in all my Monster Hunter experience, which isn't all that much for a Monster Hunter game, but like I said, for me, that's pretty goddamn impressive. No, fucking stop limping away, I need to kill you. Oh, you penis. You see? I say that, and then someone in chat's like, only 400 hours? Yeah, that's how crazy this game can get. 400 hours is nothing for many Monster Hunter fans. Dinosaur, can you fucking die already? Alright, weapon power decreased means I need to now sharpen my switch axe. Do I risk poisoning myself for another hit? Yes. I'm on the aggressive now. And it's dead. Now if you thought that was barbaric, I need to skin it. So so that I may make armor and weapons from its hide. So you'll see, again, this is for the newer players. Most Monster Hunter people know this already. Well, they do know this already, but in the top left, you'll see a green sword. That is my sharpness level. Green is standard. Meaning you do, like, I think, standard amount of damage. My weapon, this particular weapon I have, goes to blue. Which is really sharp, meaning it does maximum damage at blue. So I'm gonna sharpen it with the whetstone, and you'll see the sword has turned blue. And that, right there, will last a while. And it actually lasts double as long as it normally would. Whoops. Oh, you fuckers, stop it! I'm trying to mine stupid stones that I probably don't need anymore. So, my weapon sharpness lasts double as long as it normally would. Oh. Because I have this particular skill, which is called Razor Sharp. Razor Sharp, I think, increases the lifespan of your sharpness level by 50%. So I can essentially attack longer without having to sharpen my weapon. Top sharpness is purple. Right. I have a weapon that actually has a higher sharpness level, which is a really, it can only hit like 5 times before it loses sharpness from that level, but those few hits are pretty goddamn amazing. So, I'll show you, I only have a few weapons that I really use. I only opted to really master, which you can barely say I've done because I haven't. But, I've only decided to go for 2 weapon mains, which is, the Switch Axe and the Charge Blade. And both of those weapons are really cool. I like them a lot. I used to be, a boner in Monster Hunter 3 Ultimate. I used, bows. So, I did that, and then I was like, you know what, I want to do melee again. Hello, friend! Look at them, they're playing their cat song. I used great swords, I've used Sword and Shield, I've used lances in Monster Hunter Tri. So I've experimented with a great number of different weapons in this series. In Monster Hunter Tri, I was way more adventurous. Whoa, you motherfucker! Cool depth perception, Vin. Well, I've knocked him down. I can't get down there from this angle. By the time he gets back up, I may as well not even go down there, so. Come on. Come back up. Come back up. Why Monster Hunter requires a lot of patience. There's a lot of times it's easy to miss or get frustrated that your attacks aren't killing the monsters. Like, seriously, it takes... You can probably tell, but it does take quite a long time to kill these monsters. Right into the poison. Good job. And my cats are fucking on point. Get out of here, Raptor. I envy ranged classes, having switched back to melee. I like melee more, but ranged, there's something to be said for ranged when here I am avoiding the poison. I'm gonna go for the poison, I don't care anymore. Here we go, super attack. Yeah, fuck you. Note that attack that I was just doing, the axe swing, takes up stamina. Really, really worth it, though, for the amount of damage it does. Do I just zone? I don't want to zone. See that balloon up there? Check the map. You see what it did? That balloon just gave me the location of the fucking monster. When you wave at the balloon, it'll tell you where the monster went. That is a trick a surprising number of people don't know. I didn't know that for a long time. Celtis is recharging. Vinesauce, did you see the guy breaking his keyboard because of Darkest Dungeon? No. No. I would tweet that to me if you can. I would love to see that. I've been tempted to break my keyboard while playing that game. I'm not surprised someone has. I tried to do something cool, but I realized I don't remember how to do climbing tactics anymore. Again, for anyone just joining, I haven't played Monster Hunter, like, seriously, in a year, almost. Little under a year. So, I forgot a lot of things. Alright. Nice. So there you go, that's basically, that is me just doing a quest as Skullface on my own. Just Skullfacing it, you know. Look at that handsome fighter. So handsome. No. And then at the end, you get more rewards. And a lot of these rewards have varying degrees of rarity. I don't know which, if any of these are rare. Monster fluid's usually pretty good to have. I remember I had to grind for monster fluid one time. Then the cats pick up some shit too. Ooh! What do we got here? These are, talismans, which you can get some skills with. I'll hold on to them. I usually do, because I don't really feel like sorting through. Alright, thanks, ComJ. I'll show that at the end of the stream. I'll take a look at it. But for now, I'm just gonna play a little bit more. Like I was saying the other day, I had to kill, like, 14 or 15 Rathians just to get one piece that I needed, which was a Rathian plate, which is the hardest item to get from a Rathian, right? 2% drop rate. I had to kill, like, 14, 15 of them, and then I finally got it. I was finally able to do what I needed to do, but it took me a fucking forever. Worth it in the end, because that's what Monster Hunter is all about. The grind. Which is also why I stopped playing it. But it's just something so... There's something so zen about this game. And so fucking awesome about the controls and... This is actually... That wasn't even my best weapon, by the way. The one I was using, Demolition X. It's the most powerful from a purely raw stat-based... perspective, but I mean, look at this one. This one's pretty badass. Let me show you what this one even looks like. This one's so fucking cool. And then there's this one, which is another fucking badass one. Let's see what skills I have. I have critical eye plus 2 with this one. See this axe, the Mundus Altus, which is basically like a chainsaw. This has its own stats. So it's got it's got expert plus 3, which I've given to it because it has slots. Slots are basically just empty spots, like materia almost, but for stats. That's the real thing. Like, yeah, defense armor gives you defense, but you also want those active skills. So critical eye is really good for damage. Defense up is obviously good for defense. So I kind of mix and match a little bit. But I'm going to use this one. This one's really cool. So, from here forward, I am going to... I guess we'll do an online thing. What do you see, you little bastards, huh? If you want to join in, you know how to do it, maybe. Alright, I don't know how to fucking do it. How do you fucking do this? How do you do this? No, I'm serious. World map, there it is. So, again, just like Final Fantasy Explorers, there's, you make a gathering hall, so I'm gonna do this one. I guess we'll do any. Just, G, you know what? Yeah, any. I haven't done any G-rank stuff yet, though, so I'm a little bit skittish about that. Password is 4,000 again. Join in, and we'll kill a monster or two. 4,000 is the code, and the info is Where is the info? Gathering Hall ID, right there, you see it? It's 32-75, well, you get the idea. So, 32, 75, 35, 53, 45, 68, 05. So we've got Rachel, Telfair, Skullfight. And Lune. Suddenly I feel inadequate. Rachel, you play this game a lot, don't you? Holy shit. Look at this. Maybe. That's a nice fucking sword. Holy shit. Look at that. That looks so fucking cool. I've said this in the past, but the Monster Hunter community is some of the best people in video games. I mean that. People are willing to help. And help you, like, get experience. They will sacrifice their time to get you that piece of equipment you need. I don't know. I am so worried. I really don't know. Gold Rathian, huh? Fuck it, let's kill a Gold Rathian. That seems like something that I can maybe do. I'm gonna go for defense. Hairy tuna plus bread? No. That's health and stamina and attack. I don't want- oh, attack is nice, but... what is it? It's like cola and mushroom and thing? No. Fish plus bread. We're gonna dunk it with a G rank. Oh, that's cool. At least it'll be fun to watch. Then we can do another monster after that. Let me just, have you guys been playing since launch? The people that are in the room right now? Just give me an @vinesauce in the chat, or I guess you can just do it in the in-game chat too, is fine. Yes. Well, that explains a little bit. The crazy thing is, though, this game is addictive enough that it's certainly possible to play this game since launch and still have some fun. And there was lots of DLC. There was lots of free DLC. Hello, Gold Rathian friend. So, They have the insect staff, which is a really bizarre weapon, but really, really cool. It's a long-ranged slash short-ranged weapon that increases your mobility, allows you to jump up in the air and do some fun stuff like that. And we have one greatsword, and then me with the switch axe. Try to chop its tail off. Whoa, that's a lot of damage. Ain't that right, Jim? Yep, that's totally right, Chad. Go for me. Don't fucking attack me. Yeah, you guys have fun carrying me. I'm just gonna go ahead and loot and carve the tail. Oh, I did a little something. See, when you mount the monster, if I were to attack it, it would make the monster more irate. And then, okay, mounting the monster successfully means you can stun it and do that, which is great because you get a bunch of hits in. Ooh. Oh, that sucks. Oh, that was the C4 plant. Someone planted an explosive near his head. It's head. Hey, wait. Is this a Rathian or a Rathalos? I'm not sure. I forgot. Wow. That was stupid quick. Well, if I ever need gold Rathian stuff, I've got it right here. That was really, really quick. This was a Rathian, so it's a girl. That's the female. The Rathalos is the male of the species. Sean Connery saying species is not something that would work very well, would it?
Species.
Don't kick. How can she kick? Remember, oh, Rathian Ruby, that's good, right? That's rare 7, that's probably really good. Some rare 5s. Ancient Shard, oh, that should be interesting. Wrath Medulla, oh man, I remember having to farm those. Monster hard bone, yeah. Oh, look at this, I got a thing, I got a weapon. It's a blue crater, it's a lance. Nice. I don't know if it's any good, but it can be upgraded to be good, eventually. Someone in chat just said, I've been fucking farming Azure Wrath and for a fucking ruby, and I haven't gotten it yet. Meanwhile, here I am, with no sense of the value of this particular ruby, because I forgot so much of this game. And I'm just like, yeah, I'll take the ruby, sure. Let's do another one, since you guys are gonna carry me. I'm gonna switch weapons, though. Oh, well, there's a spot open. If anyone wants to join. Khan entered. Oh, no, I already made the charm. The Rathian. I needed the plate, and I already did it, so it's all good. So this is the other weapon type that I use, which, is my only rare 7 weapon. It's kind of a sword and shield that turns into an axe. Notice I use axes, which is strange because in most games, like, an axe is not my favorite medieval weapon by a long shot. I actually don't think axes are all that cool, but I do like swords. That said, these two particular weapons, the switch axe and the charge blade, I think are the coolest weapons in the game. In my opinion. I like their special abilities. Event quests. Supersonic Sergios out of time. Oh my god. Just gonna do, we can do an advanced devil. We can do a Devil Joe and Rajang. Rajang. Not sure. Yeah, I'm gonna do this one. Advanced high rank. I don't think we can do a G rank. Right now. I'm not feeling very confident about that. These people are really good. But I'm not that good. And I will die. This is gonna be a hard quest too. This is Uncle Joe. have you guys visited Uncle Joe? It's been a while, huh? You're gonna see firsthand the beauty of Uncle Joe. And then the Rajang is gonna be a motherfucker. Of the highest degree. These enemies, these monsters that we're fighting are just scumbags. Trash Pickle comes to life. Actually, I've often said that this Devil Joe monster looks a lot like a pickle. Guys, this Devil Joe you're about to witness is the embodiment of the Trash Pickle. It is a Trash Pickle come to life. How about this? I forgot to change the description on YouTube to Monster Hunter. It still says Final Fantasy Explorers. People are gonna join and not know the difference anyway, so maybe I shouldn't care too much. Okay. Problem solved. Get ready to see a living Trash Pickle. I'll just stay here and look at all these nice mountains while you guys while you guys kill Uncle Joe. How's that sound? Finally, my revenge on Trash Pickle. There it is. Oh, that's a big one! That's a big Joe! This is one of the few monsters that actually scares the shit out of me, for a number of reasons. Oh, it's in rage mode. Now it's a bloody Trash Pickle. Note that the axe turns into a sword and shield combo. Don't look at me. Do not look at me, Mr. Devil Joe. Telfair is a brave soul. What? No, no, no. What are you doing? No. Don't start picking up sleep herbs. So the way this weapon works is you charge it. When I hit with the sword, it charges. You'll notice the charge in the top left, they're yellow now. There's five, what they're called, files. Not to be confused with X-Files, by the way. I saw the second episode of the new series. I don't know if I told you, but I watched it yesterday and it was awesome. X-Files is back. The first episode may have been a little weak, but the second one was an X-Files episode through and through. Ooh, I got some good hits in there. It wasn't a perfect episode by any means, but it was definitely good. I'm very hopeful for the third one. Oh no, the Rajang is here too. Okay, everyone follow the fucking Devil Joe. Ignore Rajang. Motherfucker! Yeah, I don't like that monster. That monster, no. That monster makes me poop a little. I zoned. Shit. It's okay, I need to sharpen anyway. You see how quick my white sharpness level went down? Even with my sharpness skill. Super fucking quick. Yeah, use that axe, boy! You can unleash some really fucking devastating attacks with the axe. Oh, Devil Joe's dead. Wow, I didn't do a whole lot that fight at all, huh? Good job, everyone. Trash Pickle Revenge. Yeah, there's been revenge on the Trash Pickle, finally. This motherfucker. Trying to stand behind the trap. Oh! Looks like they've mounted the beast yet again. I can't do anything. I can't attack because there's explosions happening. Alright, so there's so many other functions to this weapon that I didn't even get a chance to show you guys. This is a very good group of people. Did you see his face? Did you see that fucking face? So this is now, my shield has got power, right? And if I use it at exactly the right time, I can do some cool shit. But if I do something else, I can charge it even further and get a super attack. It's not an easy thing to do, but when you do it, it is so satisfying. It does so much damage, and I just took so much damage. No. That was not a good time. I thought I was pressing the potion button. I wasn't. Okay, here we go. I got it. Go like that. Switch to my axe. And, oh, never mind. Motherfucker just left. I'm not gonna be able to do it. I can't unleash the full force of all of my attacks. Yet. Maybe I will be able to. Maybe if I'm lucky. Yes, I did it! Yes! I did something. I was useful. That attack took all of my charges. Nice. Now we'll find out what the inside of a Rajang looks like. Pretty cool, there's people in here. There's people inside of it. Fuck you, little dinosaurs. God damn it. I'll do one more hunt with a new group of people. So a few other people get a chance to join. Anyone who doesn't get a chance to join, I apologize. Keep in mind, it is a very difficult thing. There's a few thousand people in here, so... Even if there's only 100 people that have Monster Hunter, and then only 20 that want to play online, that's still 20 people. So... So yeah, Rachel Telfair Khan, thank you for playing. I'm going to sadly ask you to leave. One day I'll be able to use these monster parts and build something with them, I don't know what. See ya. Okay, room info, once again, is this right here. You'll see Gathering Hall ID on the screen. And, it's 32, 75, 35, 53, 45, 6805. Password for the room is 4000. Join in. So Duncan, hello. RME, hello. Everyone here is like fucking massively leveled. Jesus. Oh yeah, Xerxes. Yeah, scissor me timber, Xerxes. Hi. I don't want to do an incredibly long mission. Let's do the Diora. That could be a long mission, but fuck it, let's go out in style. It's a big fucking dragon. Oh, you got the Mega Man cat. Nice. Oh, that's awesome. Whoa, disappeared. The hell? Person with Mega Man cat, you just disappeared. Also, I am actually looking to, if anyone here does music PR, I'm thinking about getting, some way to get my music out to, like, blogs and stuff. Nothing too crazy, but I figured it would be wise if I put all this work into this album. I may as well try to get the word out a little bit. So, if anyone does music PR, I've already got a few places I'm gonna email and, check out. But if you know anything about it, shoot me an email. So, RME, Xerxes, and Duncan! You guys are gonna dance. And you're all G rank. Oh yeah, there is a Steam group for Monster Hunter, a Vinesauce Monster Hunter page. If you want to join it, can someone, find a link? Where can you find my album? Well, it's not done yet, but if you want to hear my music, it's just vine.bandcamp.com. Album should be done in like a few weeks, to be honest. So... But yeah, What was I gonna say? I was talking to someone. Oh, there it is, the Steam community, thank you. Oh, I forgot to eat. God damn it. I knew I was busy yapping about nonsense. I forgot to have the cats cook me some food. And that is a mistake I might end up regretting. But yeah, there it is in the chat. Indie punk rocker. Yeah, I mean, if you want to do so, if you know how to promote, send me an email. I mean, I have money. I have enough to buy a few pickles here and there. So, I mean, I'd be happy to. Like, I'm not looking for free service. I just don't know how to go about any of this shit. This is all my first time. Also, I'm forgetting to. Here I am, like, mining stuff while fucking murder monster. Like something out of one of Geiger's paintings just decides that it wants to fucking eat my testicles. Man, I am so ready. If someone could just stun it for a little bit, I can make some good things happen. I have a full charge. My axe can unleash the fury of Satan's cock. Nice. Here it is. Here it is! Yeah! Probably just woke up a lot of people. I'm sorry. Not really. I forgot to press the button. I fucked that one up. Oops. Alright, let's just do some damage the old-fashioned way. Nice, got that tail off. That's a lot of damage. That is a lot of damage! No! This is why you should never forget to eat, kids. Always have the cats make you a nice, hot, fresh meal. If I had extra defense, I probably would have survived. Apparently he doesn't know about item sets or doesn't use them. What? I know... I'm mixing and matching right now. But I have the full set of a number of monsters. How could you play 400 hours of Monster Hunter and not know about item, weapon, armor sets, rather? This is a mix and match set. Which I think is actually even a little bit harder to figure out, because you have to make everything work in, kind of in harmony with each other, which isn't always easy. Item set Oh, you mean, like, in the box? Muffled screams in the distance. Item sets are for consumables you bring in hunts, not armor. Oh, well now I feel like a douche. Sorry. I thought you meant armor sets. My bad, dude. Where'd it go? No. Yeah, I don't know about item sets. I probably have seen the option, but I usually just end up kind of just taking what I need. I never really found it too much of a hassle, but I'll probably end up looking into it next time I'm not streaming the game and I play it, just to see if I can make myself some kind of custom item set of all the items I use. I did the tail already. I got the tail. By the way, this dragon, I mean, you saw how much damage it did to me. This is a really fucking hard monster. I don't know if the enormity of how hard this monster is striking, because it's generally not attacking me. Okay, never mind, it's an easy monster. Keep in mind, I am with people very highly ranked. But this motherfucker is a monster that I would not like to fight alone. He moves around a lot, he's fast, he's got some ranged attacks, and his skin is made of leather. Oh, I fought Dalamadur. The fight's kind of boring. I've already fought Dal. It's fun to watch, but it's kind of not necessarily a fun fight to participate in, I feel. I don't know. Ooh, I got a gem. Kind of crap stuff. Alright. I did it. I even ranked up tonight. Sorry, oh, you want a Moran fight? I'll tell you what, I can do this. I'm gonna exit the lobby. Thank you guys, Duncan, RME, Xerxes. Thank you guys so much for carrying me. It was fun. Like I said, I'm at this point, the people that join my streams are just super, super over leveled. Not, well, over equipped, I would say. And over leveled too, but that's, there's no levels. Like, your base stats never really increase or anything like that. It's just your armor, your weapons, and what fights you can participate in. And of course, your own personal skill level. You know, and knowing how to react to different monsters. That's super important. I enjoyed it. And I will stream another Monster Hunter stream. You know, it's funny because this was a request I was getting for a while. People were like, Vinny, when are you going to stream Monster Hunter again? When are you going to stream Monster Hunter again? And I was like, I kind of don't have any motivation. Because if it's like an overly complex game like this, where if I don't play it for like 9 months, I forget shit very quickly. not just in this game, but in life. You know, I don't think I'd remember my middle name if it wasn't something I have to write on a thing every now and then. So I feel like something like Monster Hunter, it's not an easy game to jump back into. It's not an easy game to remember, but I forced myself because, again, you know, I'm sitting in Joe's studio and he's the master. I don't want to get in his way. He's amazing at what he does. All I can do is really offer suggestions or give him like a direction for where, you know, we can fix things or make things sound better on the music. So I am, you know, while we're recording, which was last year, but so far this year, we've been mixing and that's just his thing, you know, and then I might be necessary for like a total of 45 minutes out of a 6 hour session. And it's sporadic when it happens, but, you know, it's good to be there because I can have control over what's happening. That said, the other however many hours, I'm just sitting there. You know, I'm listening to the same song over and over again, or just the drums isolated, you know, with 1,000 different types of reverb on them for like 2 hours. And it's, I love it. It's fascinating, you know, but it's not like I'm learning. It's more his preference and finding the right thing. So I am just sitting there, like I said. So I bring books. I read that Han Solo book I told you about. I've been reading the David Byrne book about the business of music. I'm on that chapter. I have read the Star Trek book. I've been playing SteamWorld Dig, SteamWorld Heist to finish those two. And then I started saying to myself, I was like, well, you know, I have Mario Golf with me, Castlevania, which I didn't finish, or Monster Hunter. And I said, Monster Hunter. All right, fine. I'll boot it up and see what happens. And the first time I played it, I fought one monster just to get back into it. And I just sucked. And I was like, I don't think I want to play this. This is just too complicated for me right now. I started getting a headache, put it away. But yet that one play session of Monster Hunter was good enough for me. And then for some reason, the next day, I was just like, even though I didn't particularly enjoy playing Monster Hunter, I kind of want to play it again. So I played it again. And then I started looking at my stats and I was like, you know, if I get one sharpness gem and put this in this thing, I can get sharpness plus one, which is a really cool skill to have. But I have to kill a Rathian. I was like, I can kill a Rathian. So I was killing Rathians in 5 minutes. The, you know, not the high rank ones, the low rank ones. I was like, fuck it. I'll probably have to kill like 2 Rathians, 3 Rathians. I'll get my plate, get my gem, and then maybe I'll see if I'm interested in the game. I don't know. I'm not really too interested right now, but if I get this gem, maybe it'll give me a mission, something to do, something to work towards, because God knows where I am in G rank. I don't know what equipment I need. I still don't know what equipment I need. Maybe if I do it again, maybe someone can point me in the right direction for a good armor set or something. I don't know. So I have no idea what to work towards, right? And then the Rathian, 2 turned into 4, 4 turned into 6, 6 to 8, 8 to 10, and then finally 14 Rathians later, I get my gem. And then I'm like, well, now I'm enjoying the game again. And now I want to do other things. So that's where I'm at. Monster Hunter, you roped me back in, you son of a bitch. Great game, though. Really is. And I'm not too upset that I got roped back in. I don't feel like I'm going to end up playing it every day, but I'll probably do a stream of it here and there. Pop it on for a little bit. And kill a monster or two. And that is my story of Monster Hunter 4. And this is my drawing. Let's check the art, shall we?